The symbol. It's the same as on my medal.
Yeah. That's what I wanted to show you. Do you understand any of this?
No. And what is this?
No idea. There's no button, no lever, nothing. Whoa. What did you do?
Nothing. I just waved my medal and...
Are you telling me that your medal is actually some kind of key?
I have no idea. But in any case, it's open. So are we gonna check out the other side?
Of course. Unless you have a better idea. Okay, then. These buildings are a lot more sinister than the others. Do you think that's the experimental plant my mom mentioned?
Very likely so.
Which blew everything up. It doesn't look so big.
I'm guessing it goes deep, though.
I don't understand. How could such a small drill cause an entire planet to explode?
I guess it acted as a catalyst.
Sorry, I still don't understand.
I'm not sure I understand it either. At best, I have a hypothesis. Whatever that's worth.
Please, tell me.
Okay, so, you know how the planets are set up, kind of?
A big flow core with crust all around it.
That's right. Irena said the plant was sourcing flow directly at the core, and that it was condensing into a solid state to facilitate transport.
So that would be the rust?
No. Actually, I'm thinking of something else. Whatever it was, something went wrong. And instead of condensing normally, the flow degraded into rust. And this degradation would have propagated along the drill path and into the core.
Okay, there's no need to use air quotes every time.
Sorry.
So, then?
Well, kind of like water and ice, if you will. The rust occupied more space than flow. When the flow core turned into rust, it expanded against the crust all around it, which ended up cracking. Kind of like leaving a bottle in the freezer for too long.
And the rust leaked out of the cracks?
I guess so. Otherwise, it came out of geysers, volcanoes, whatever.
Okay. That makes sense. Which leads me to my second question. Why do you have the key to this thing around your neck?
If I knew.
What was that you picked up?
I'm trying to figure it out. It looks like rust, but it's a lot heavier and slicker.
Let me see. Hey, it's kind of warm, too.
Weird, huh?
Do you think that's what they were making here? The, ultra-concentrated flow thing?
Yes, possibly. I'd need some time to analyze it in the nest.
So, is this rust or is this not rust?
Depends on how you define rust.
A kind of ruddy substance that dissolves in flow?
Then it's not rust. It has the same components, but no matter how much flow I throw at it, it won't budge. On the contrary, flow seems to evaporate when they come into contact.
Evaporate?
Yeah, I don't know if that's the right word. It's absorbed, consumed? I mean, it disappears.
Oh yeah, then it's like hyper rust.
If you will.
So, to summarize, hyper-rust dissolves flow, which dissolves rust. Maybe rust dissolves hyper-rust. That would be like rock, paper, scissors.
No, rust and hyper-rust, as you call it, have no effect upon one another.
Too bad. I really like rock, paper, scissors. I win every time.
I know. And I still don't understand how you do it. It's statistically impossible.
If you think rock, paper, scissors has to do with statistics, you have really missed the point of rock, paper, scissors.
One day I will uncover this mystery.
All in due time. First, hyper-rust. then rock, paper, scissors.